Hey everyone, want to bring back Windows XP on your Windows 11 PC? Whether it's for nostalgia or running old software, this guide will help you out. In this video, I will show you how to install Windows XP on a virtual machine step by step. So without further delay, let's begin the process. First, we need to download the Windows XP ISO file. As you know, Windows XP has been archived by Microsoft. But don't worry, I will show you how to get it for free, okay? So for this, open this archive.org website. I have given the link in the description. From here, you will get the Windows XP 32-bit ISO file along with the product key visible on the page, you can see. On the right-hand side, under the download options, you will see ISO image. Just click on it and the download will begin. The file size is around 600 MB, so depending on your internet speed, this may take some time. Now, we need virtual machine to run Windows XP. And for that, we will use VirtualBox. Open your web browser to type VirtualBox and go to the VirtualBox website. Click on the download button. Choose the package for your operating system, whether it is for Windows, macOS or Linux. I am going to click the link for Windows host to download the installer for Windows. Once downloaded, double click the installer file to begin the installation process. And here you need to follow the on-screen instruction. Just click next, next and it will install. It's very easy. Only stick to the default settings. Okay. Once completed, click finish. Now that we have Windows XP ISO downloaded and VirtualBox installed, it's time to create the virtual machine and install Windows XP on it. Open VirtualBox and click on New. In the name field, you need to give one name. Here I am going to type Windows XP. Under ISO image, select the Windows XP ISO file you downloaded. Then check the box Keep Unattended Installation. Then click Next. In the memory allocation sections, you need to set at least 2 GB of RAM, or you can use more if you have enough RAM. Okay. And in the processor allocation, set at least 2 cores. After that, click Next. You need to select Create a Virtual Hard Disk Now and set the disk size to minimum 20 GB, or you can allocate more if you have enough space. Then click Next, then Finish. Before starting, you need to click Settings and then go to the Display and increase the video memory to maximum. Then click OK. Now the virtual machine setup is ready. Let's install Windows XP. So click Start to boot from the ISO file. The Windows XP setup will start. You will see setup is starting Windows, and here you need to press Enter to begin the installation. Press F8 to accept the license agreement. Press Enter to install Windows XP on the selected partition. Now you need to choose format the partition using the NTFS file system, quick, and press Enter. Setup will format the virtual disks and start copying files. This may take some time, so wait until it finishes. Okay. After copying files, the VM will restart automatically. The Windows XP installation will continue with the graphical setup. And here, configure the region and language options of Windows XP. You can customize according to your country. Then click on Next. And here you need to type a name of your user account you will use in your virtual system. Okay, so I'm going to name it Tech Infokart. And in organization name, I'm going to write Home. And then click Next. In this page, enter a Windows XP product key. You can copy the product key from the site, or you can also find the desired product key for the same in the description below. Okay. And finally click Next. And in this space, type the computer name you want to use and create a new password for the administrator account. But I'm going to leave this field blank to avoid making a password. Okay. Then click on Next. Configure your virtual computer date, time and time zone settings according to your location. And click Next. Choose whether to use typical or custom settings. I am going to select typical and click on Next. And here select Workgroup and click Next. Now wait while Windows XP is installed. After the Windows XP system files are copied, your system will reboot. And your desktop will be ready. You must hear the old nostalgic Windows XP sound, isn't it? Okay, so after completing and finalizing the setup process of Windows XP on VirtualBox, you will have the familiar desktop interface of it. You can also set up the desktop icon according to your need. And here, one thing you must notice that you can't make this full screen by default. For that, we have to install VirtualBox Guest Edition in Windows XP. To enable this, click on Devices, then click on Insert Guest Edition CD Image. After that, open My Computer inside Windows XP and double click on the VirtualBox Guest Edition drive. Then click on Next. Again click on Next. And finally click on Install. This will start the installation. Once the installation is done, just reboot your system. Now click on View and then select Full Screen Mode. And click on Switch on the screen that appears. Finally, you will get the fully working Windows XP with full screen on your physical Windows 11. And that's it guys, you have successfully installed Windows XP on VirtualBox inside Windows 11. Now you can run old software, play classic games or just experience the nostalgia of Windows XP. If this video helped you, don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the bell icon too, so you are the first to watch my next video. Try this setup yourself and share your experience in the comments. Thanks for watching.